Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. I've been testing iOS 16 on my trusty iPhone 12 over here the last week, and I've come up with a list of 14 settings you'll want to change right away once you upgrade to iOS 16. Beta 5 just came out for developers this week, so we're getting pretty close to the full launch and there's some interesting quality of life changes here. And by the way, if you want the wallpaper here, I usually get questions on it. I'll share a link to it in the description box. So the very first iOS 16 setting to change is to make sure that the battery percentage is on. Yes, it is finally back for the first time since Apple removed it in 2017 on the iPhone X. This may not be on as default, it wasn't for me. So to do this, go into setting, then scroll down to battery, and then in battery, toggle on the battery percentage here. So the battery icon does become slightly larger than normal. I'll show you here. If I turn it on and off, it does become slightly larger to accommodate for the numbers, but it's a minuscule trade-off for something I find so useful anyway. No more having to, you know, slide down the control center just to check if you're at 10% battery or living life on the edge at 1%. And yes, I am on pretty low percentage right now. The next thing I think everyone should change has to do with the side power button. If you've ever been on a call and, you know, you accidentally hit the side button, you'll know it prematurely ends the call, and it drove me crazy because it happened quite a lot to me. And we now, thankfully, in iOS 16 have the option to prevent that from happening completely. And to do that, you go into settings again, and then you scroll down to accessibility. And then from here, you go into touch, right here. And then from touch, you go all the way down and you have now an option to prevent lock to end call. So I've turned this on already. And what this does is if you now accidentally tap the side button, your screen goes to sleep during a call, but you'll stay on your phone call. I think this should be a default, and I genuinely wonder how many people actually use the side button to end calls. If you're one of them, let me know down below. The next new feature to turn on is the haptic keyboard. It's a feature I've been wanting ever since the introduction of the Taptic engine on the iPhone 7. And I know Android users are probably laughing right now, but surely I can't be the only one excited about this feature, right? So to turn the haptic engine on for the keyboard, you scroll down into settings again and go into sound and haptics. And then from here, you go into keyboard feedback, and haptic is on default off. So just turn that on, and then you've got haptic feedback for your keyboard. So far, I think it's a little weak feeling at the moment. So hopefully it's just a beta thing. I think it'd be really cool to see an option to change the haptic feedback sensitivity for typing specifically. And just a heads up, I believe on silent mode, haptic feedback will still be there unless you completely turn it off, at least in beta right now. So you probably already know that the lock screen has transformed in iOS 16, and there's a lot you can do here. But there is one setting that's a must for the minimalists out there, which I absolutely love, and it's under notifications. And under notifications in iOS 16, you now have this display as option. So you get count, stack, and list. By default, it's stack, but I recommend changing it to count. This will turn all notification bubbles to a small number at the bottom of the lock screen, and clicking them will reveal them. So right now I've got do not disturb mode here, but the notifications will pop up here as a number. And then when you click on them, you'll reveal them. And this keeps a home screen forever clean and keeps me focused rather than catching, you know, like a glimpse of a text that usually distract me. I highly recommend switching over to this view and giving it a go. If you want to automatically bypass those annoying ass, you know, capture forms, we now have a nifty feature from Apple called automatic verification to save us the time and hassle. To turn this on, go into settings, Apple ID, and then password and security. Then scroll all the way down, and that's where you'll see the feature to toggle on. And there is a catch though, it doesn't work on every single website right now. It works only on sites hosted on Fastly or Cloudflare CDN. These are the two companies who have been working with Apple to develop a new privacy pass protocol, which basically keeps our data anonymous during the token verification process, such as capture. So I guess in a way, the robots of iOS 16 are telling captures that we're not a robot. Thanks, iOS 16. For those who use Spotlight to search for things all the time like I do, you'll want to make sure the new Spotlight feature is turned on in iOS 16. It's this little search button here, and if you click it, you can immediately use Spotlight. You get to still, you know, drag it around and search the pages and whatnot, but once you let go, it goes back to the search function. So to turn this on, go into settings and then the home screen menu right here, and you can see the function show on home screen. So you can turn it off or turn it back on, up to depending on your preference. If you're big on privacy and protecting your own data, then the next feature you'll definitely want to turn on when you upgrade to iOS 16. It's Apple's new safety check feature, and it allows you to immediately revoke access to private data from both people and apps from a single spot. So jump into settings again, go into privacy and security, and then I believe it's all the way down at the bottom, safety check right here. And so once you enable it, you get two different functions now, and you get emergency reset and a managed sharing and access functions. I believe it's designed for those at risk of domestic abuse originally, but it's also really useful for easily managing who you're sharing private data with. There is even, if we go back out here, this really intense lockdown mode. And this new hardcore lockdown mode is to defend against what Apple calls highly targeted cyber attacks by paring back what's accessible on your iPhone and turning it into essentially Fort Knox. And so this is how you turn it on. Just a heads up, if you do turn it on, you need a hard reset to get out of this mode. Talking about privacy, here's another setting you guys should turn off in iOS 16 in the same privacy settings. So if we scroll down, privacy and security, now go into location services and scroll all the way down into system services. Now, this is something that you should definitely turn off, and it's significant locations. So if we leave this on, it's going to keep a log of your movement every day, which is not only slightly invasive, but it'll also eat up your battery life and data. So I'm going to turn this off. And then if we scroll back out, you want to go through these toggles here and see what's not applicable for you, because it's worth turning off other location tracking settings here, because, you know, same reason. So I turn things off that I personally don't find that I need, which is compass calibration, device management, and location-based suggestions. Personally, I don't find a need for these, so I would go through these and see what's applicable to you, what's not applicable, and turn them off. In the weather app, there is now an option to turn on notifications for severe weather events for multiple cities rather than just when it starts to rain or snow. So go into the weather app and then click the three dots here and then click notifications. Under current location, you can now see two new functions, severe weather and next hour precipitation. I've turned these both on. And next hour precipitation is also pretty useful if you want to keep updated on the hourly weather on your new lock screen. The next feature is an easy way to clear up precious storage space, and it's a new duplicate folder photos. So when you go into photos now, and then you scroll all the way down, you're going to see a new folder and it's called duplicates. Click on it and you're going to get all the duplicates within your photo album. I recommend taking a look at this folder right away as soon as it's found the duplicates and once you've upgraded to iOS 16, because boy, I found so many useless duplicate photos over the years to delete. So you can either delete them or you can click this merge button. And when you merge the duplicates, it automatically keeps one photo, I believe based on photo quality, and it deletes the other dupes. So if I try it out here, and click merge, merge two items, automatically does it for you, and then you have the high quality one in your photo album. Screenshots are also a big contributor to mess in my albums, and there is now a feature that I absolutely love where when you screenshot, so if I take a screenshot right now, there is now an option to click onto it, click done, and then there is a copy and delete function. This is a lifesaver because this is perfect for the times I want to screenshot something and paste it into messages, for example, but I don't want it saved in my album because most of the time anyway, I'm going back in there to delete it. This is a big time saver feature. So you just click that, it's gone, and then it's copied onto your clipboard. That was more a feature that I wanted to show you and share rather than a setting. But yeah, a really great one to have. The next setting you guys need to change is inside mail actually. And this one's important and I highly recommend turning this one on. If you use Mail, then go scroll all the way down to the Mail app. And then in Mail, go into Privacy Protection and turn on Protect Mail Activity. This is quite important because this feature hides your IP address and prevents senders from tracking when and if you open their emails. It's a really good one to have turned on, especially if you connect to public networks, and this feature is switched off by default. So yeah, make sure to turn this one on. Now back into the settings, let's go into Focus and go into Focus Status. There is now a new section here in iOS 16 where you get to share specific focus statuses. And this is pretty useful because previously I had share focus settings turned off because I don't feel, you know, the need to have my entire contact list know what I'm doing every moment of the day. But I do personally like to share work because this is a time when I generally cannot reply, and so it's useful for others to know. Everything else I have switched off here. And also, it'd probably be useful to create a custom focus status mode where it's in driving, so it detects when I'm connected to CarPlay, and so people know that I definitely can't reply then because I'm driving. If you're a gamer, you're going to love this next iOS 16 feature. You can now pair your Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons with your iPhone or iPad. And this is a game changer, you know, when playing mobile games like Call of Duty Mobile here. And so how to do this to pair them up, you flip this around and then you click your Joy-Con's black button at the back, hold it down until the green light comes up. And so once it flashes, you're going to essentially go into iPhone's Bluetooth and then connect the Joy-Cons. This is out of battery, so I can't connect it right now. But yeah, it seems to work no problem at all. And this is pretty awesome for gamers out there. If you made it to the very end of this video, drop the code word comment frenzyOS and I'll give it a like. If you found this video useful, drop a like as well and be sure to subscribe for more. If you also have a MacBook, I'll share a video on screen here where I share the must-have apps that I use on the daily that I find really useful and you might find useful too. As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.